Well, a Memphis program to help cut utility costs for under-resourced families has more than 6 times the money to spend than it did last year. That's all thanks to you.
The Memphis Light, Gas, and Water Share the Pennies program is funded when your utility bill is rounded up to the nearest dollar, and that extra money provides money to weatherize the homes of customers who can't afford to do that themselves. Now, in the first 6 months of 2018, just over $600,000 was raised. And we have Frank with us this morning with customer service. Good to have you.
Ladies, thank you all. Good to be here.
So tell us, Mr. Fletcher, $600,000, is that correct? And that came from utility bills that are automatically rounded up to the next dollar.
That is correct. And actually, that number as of the end of June is actually around $747,000.
Wow.
That our customers has helped us raise to fund Share the Pennies program.
As opposed to like $45,000 last year, right?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Now, things changed because everyone's automatically opted in. You have to go and call or go onto the website to opt out of it. Tell us why you guys changed it.
Actually, we did change that this year, and we changed that to get the community more involved in the program. We have a very high energy burden here in Memphis.
Right.
And what we thought, we could come together as a community to really solve this issue, so we did the opt-out program. So you're right, customers do have to opt out of the program, but
we were upfront, 100%.
And customers have several different ways to opt out. And we encourage customers, if you do not want to participate, we'll be more than happy to take you out of the program.
Are you surprised, though, at how many people did not opt out? Because Memphis has always been one of the top philanthropic cities
in the
nation.
If you look at some of our parent utilities that had the program, they had about 65% of customers who participated in the program.
Yeah.
But in Memphis, we have 88% of customers who are participating.
That's awesome.
That's roughly 360,000 customers.
Okay, so right now we're in the period where people can apply for some of the money to weatherize their home. Now, that started in mid-June, so are we already out of money for right now?
Now, this is what's going on with the program. So you could have registered twice this year.
Okay.
That was in January, and also in June was our application period, June 19th and 20th.
Okay.
So what we're doing now, we're going through those applications of the people who registered in June. We're still working on those clients who registered in January. And so right now we have roughly 119 customers.
Wow.
That we're working on.
Okay.
And
to get them weatherized
to find
out if they're eligible?
These are customers that actually have signed contracts or have work completed.
Okay.
We've actually completed 41 homes. Of those 41 homes, we have completed roughly $5,000 worth of work in those homes.
So where's my money going? I'm all in, so we round up. Where's the money going to, and what are the repairs that you guys are talking about?
Sure. The money is being held at MIFA. MIFA is our partner with this program, so the money's being held there. And so the program, we're doing things like water leak repairs, we're doing insulation, we're doing replacement of AC units, water heaters. So really, we're going inside of the home and seeing exactly what will help this customer lower their utility bill.
Yeah.
And so we're doing several things. And again, the funding is allowing us to do these things. Mm-hmm. Think about it. These customers getting on average $5,000 worth of work inside of their home.
That's awesome.
And these are customers who otherwise, they couldn't afford those type of repairs.
Right. We're talking about families that have to choose sometimes between new shoes for their children and food.
Absolutely.
Or paying the utility bill in full, or having transportation to work. How cool.
That's really, really awesome.
You know, those of us who are blessed can just take a few pennies, really,
right,
that we're not going to miss. So for folks who want to get it, they need to wait until January. Or if there are people who have applied in June and you find they're not eligible, they don't meet the income requirements, right, will you open up the program back
again?
We're
going to open back up the program probably sometime first quarter 2019.
Okay.
Our goal is to open up application period at least twice a year.
Okay.
And so it takes us a little while to work through the application period. But what we're finding is, on average, by the time that we actually approve the customers, it's 36 business days before the work is completed. So that's a very short time period. So it's actually working pretty well.
Yeah.
Awesome.